That's about it for books. So let's go back. YouTube has been redone for Honeycomb. So again, just to reiterate, Honeycomb is Android 3.0. It's a tablet-specific OS, not like some of our competitors, which are just phone OSs blown up, right? So this is specifically OS done just for the tablet. So you go onto YouTube, got a great layout, you've got a lot of content right at your fingertips, right off the bat. So these are all the YouTube most visited, right? So that's where I go first, right? Or I could click on browse and start going and finding new apps right now. So this will be 3G and Wi-Fi at launch. It'll be upgradable to 4G. So it's kind of future-proofing the device. As soon as 4G is available, take your device, go ahead and upgrade. Right, which is great.
You pop that baby open, throw it in 4G.
And I can't comment as to whether that's software or hardware, but...
I was going
to
say, that's
weird. So Gmail, again, redone for Honeycomb. A lot of security and encryption here as well, which is great. So if you're familiar with our Droid Pro device with Verizon, there's a lot of encryption and security. We've built in a lot of that into this device. So you see the layout's very clean. Go through, click on whatever emails you're going through. You can open and view all attachments, so your PowerPoint, Excel, etc. Do that with QuickOffice. That's kind of Gmail. So Maps, I love this. A lot of new stuff done with Maps just for Honeycomb. Let's go on and unlock. We go to Apps, which we're very familiar with. Let's say we want to start going to look for Times Square, getting some detail on Times Square. Bring up the QWERTY, start drilling in, go to Times Square. Now something you'll start to see here, which is new, is a 3D building layout, which is gorgeous. So you start seeing all the 3D. You can manipulate the display. It's a lot of touch. Move it around, rotate it however you want. And from there, we're going to go into Google Street View, which is really helpful. Flick over, you go and you scroll through. It's again, gorgeous output. It's just a very satisfying experience. You go through, you start playing with it, you kind of just fall in love with it.
That's something about the Honeycomb UI. One of the videos that shows kind of the UI, how it's
Yep, awesome. I can go through that.
Yeah.
Sure. So I'll kind of shut up a little bit and have you walk through
here. So
again, you got a lot of scrollable widgets in the UI. You go back and forth through here. So you still got a lot of your shortcuts. You got a lot of navigation at the bottom. Your settings and apps available at the top. Everything, like we talked about, is very scrollable. We don't need you going into a lot of the apps, right? That's and you can see you start pulling apps and putting them, dropping them into easily through each of the pages. Again, movable, sizable widgets. Scrolling through all YouTube videos here. So again, this is in the settings tab. That's your layout, kind of all your home screens. You can drag and drop stuff. It's just a clean clock display, kind of digital rotational display. It's your home screen. And again, very, very, very customizable, obviously, right? Any questions?
Could you just run some video on it?
Absolutely. It's actually coming out in 720p on this, so it's
the camera.
It's a 2 megapixel front-facing imager and a 5 megapixel on back for voice chat, for video chat.
Or 5 for chat?
5 on the back, 2 in the front.
So which one? Oh, so this is for chatting, right?
Right. Or you can do see what I see, right, with the 5 megapixel.
There's no audio here.
Can I hold it?
You can't actually. We're not allowed. I actually can't. I'm sorry.
You can touch it and I can hold it.
Yeah,
how about that?
I can show you guys the bag.
How heavy it is, that's all.
It's very slim. The weight is very comparable to our direct competitor.
Is that a rubber backing on there?
It's you can feel the back. It's very smooth, okay. Sleek back.
And it's only going to be available through Verizon?
Only through Verizon, correct.
Yeah. what's like service plan? I mean, like, can you
I can't speak to any of the terms or contracts.
Can you get up to like Wi-Fi at home and not go to
You can do Wi-Fi and 3G at launch, and then it'll be upgradable to 4G.
But then you don't have to.